Well, good morning, Wadsworth. How's everybody doing? You know, I always wait for that to see if anybody actually answers me, Emily, because I just know one day I'm going to hear a little voice.
The studio audience probably will.
Right.
So, well, good morning. And of course, I'm here with my dapper and beautiful co-host, Michael Reynolds from The Post.
Good morning, Janie.
Good morning. And guess what? We're also here with somebody from The Post. And a very big celebrity in our area, truly. You know, I like to say I'm a big celebrity.
Oh, well, you are.
Michael's a big celebrity.
Yes, both of you
but
are.
You have just brought a lot of news to Wadsworth that wouldn't have been in any other way be brought because your reporting is so amazing.
Oh, thank you.
So, saying that, this is Emily Canning Dean, and she's our Wadsworth reporter from the Post newspaper, the Wadsworth edition. But I do know sometimes some of your articles get in the other editions
of
the Post.
Yeah, often they're shared if they're things that, you know, might be of interest to other Medina County residents. That happens quite a bit.
So. Oh, good.
And what in Wadsworth isn't interesting to the rest
right.
of the county?
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Really, it's a great day in Wadsworth. I always say it. Yeah. Okay, so tell us, well, first of all, where did you grow up?
Well, I spent the first 12 years of my life in Akron, moved out here in 1990, so I've really been here most of my life. I'm a Grizzly, class of 1996.
Good deal.
So, yeah, actually, I graduated with your nephew, so,
Chad,
yeah.
Okay,
so.
All right, because I graduated a year before that.
Well, I thought I remembered you in high school, yeah. So.
Yeah. Okay, so you're a Grizzly through and through.
Definitely. I definitely am. I married a Wadsworth guy, and we bought a house here, and this is our home.
And your dogs are Grizzlies, too.
Yeah, well, I have a dog and a cat, and they're Grizzlies as well. So,
okay. Oh,
yeah.
That is so nice. Where did you go to college?
I went to the University of Akron, majored in English and minored in business, and didn't really quite know what I wanted to do, but I knew I wanted a writing background. And then a lady at what was once called Record Publishing Company, they had a series of weekly newspapers in Northern Summit County, gave me a chance, and I was there 11 years.
Wow.
And then Bruce and Mike Trogdon were good enough to give me a shot at the Wadsworth Post back in 2012. So
wow.
I've been here ever since.
The rest is history.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. So let's start, like, what I want to know is, what's your day like?
Oh, every day is so different, which actually that's part of what I love about this job.
Sure.
You know, it's like yesterday I spent pretty much all day in my home office just pounding out stories. Last Friday I'm wandering around down at Main Street for First Friday. A few days before that, I'm going to a couple of Medina County high schools to interview foreign exchange students. You know, in a couple of weeks, I'll be hanging out with you at the chamber for the, State of the City. So
yep.
I love that really no 2 days are alike with what I do.
So how do you do with deadlines?
Well,
because you've got a lot of deadlines, I'm sure.
I do. You know, I do. I mean, obviously, you know, we have a deadline of Monday at 5 every week to get everything and we need for the paper, but
okay.
I don't want to inundate the boys at the office with, you know, all 10 of my stories that day. So.
Sure.
And they're very thankful.
Yes, yes.
Oh,
you
that's
know.
Nice. Yeah.
Yeah. So, but really, you know, my main thing is I just try to get the news out as quickly as I can, you know. It means like kind of a lot of late nights. I think my coworkers would say they do the same. Sunday nights are still pretty much an all-nighter for most of us.
Oh, my
yeah.
gosh.
So.
There's a lot to put together
yeah.
know, with the paper. And, you know, when you're trying to fit so much information in a limited amount of space, there's a lot of editing and rewriting to say, well, I know you had 720 words, but we only can fit 690,
right, exactly.
and you want to get the same thing across. It isn't as simple as just removing 30 words.
Right. I mean, that's the problem. When you have that finite amount of space, you have to, you know, kind of learn to adjust to that. So.
And then she puts up with me all the time. Saying, can you do this, Emily? Can you put this in?
So tell me, how do you get your stories?
You know, really through a lot of different avenues. I mean, I go to a lot of city meetings, so I get stuff there.
I've seen you at many.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah. Social media is actually a big help. You know, occasionally you'll just see somebody mention something on Facebook. We actually got a Facebook post the other week about this great story that this dog in town who was on a walk with his owner and found another dog frozen in the snow and saved said dog's life. Mm-hmm. You know, we just got that from seeing it on Facebook.
Stories in the paper this week.
Yeah, yeah, the story, you'll see it, you know, this week. You know, other times, people in the community, too, are just great about giving me a heads up, you know, letting me know something's going on. Mike actually sometimes points me in the right direction, too, because he's obviously got his finger on the pulse of the community a lot.
Sure.
So, yeah, there are just so many different ways that, you know, we end up gleaning, you know, information. So
now, do you prefer like to do a phone interview with people, or do you like prefer to sit down and talk with them?
You know, especially if it's like an in-depth feature story, I think it's better person to person. You know, mm-hmm. I think you can just get a feel for the person a lot better like that. Sometimes we don't always have that kind of time, you know.
Sure.
But yeah, especially for more of a featurey story, I prefer, you know, to actually have that in person.
Now, Emily, have you, look, here I am, just, I've got all these questions. Sorry, Michael.
Not a problem.
Have you ever done a series, you know what I mean, like a story that started and you just continuously followed it?
Oh, yeah. There, you know, there have been a lot of things. Well, just there are a lot of news items that, you know, you just kind of keep following up as time goes on. Like, it was actually funny. I was having a conversation with my mom about 6 months ago, and I was talking about the trail, and she's like, there's a trail in Wadsworth? I'm like, I've written 20 stories on this, Mom. I'm like, you know, because just as things are, you know, going
thanks,
on.
Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Glad to know you've been keeping up, but.
Janie was thinking something along the lines of profiles of people in Wadsworth, and the first one can be on Janie.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There, that would be a good
there
idea.
There we go. Oh,
yeah, we
my
could do
gosh.
A series on Janie. That
don't toy with me.
Oh, that would probably be fascinating, though.
You know what I was just thinking, though, about the, I read a wonderful series in The Plain Dealer by Connie Schultz when she was writing for the, and it was called Losing Lisa, and it was the story of a lady that had been diagnosed with cancer all the way through her death and then what happened afterwards. And so it was a weekly story.
Okay.
And it was just so interesting to me.
It's probably riveting. You're right.
Oh, you know, yeah, I would think
so. Sad, but,
it,
but,
very
but
sad.
Really engaging.
But I read it when I was at hospice working for them. And so it just was like, it stuck with me for all these years about that story. And of course, I love Connie Schultz. So,
oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, I mean, who wouldn't?
Right. Yeah, yeah. No, actually, I love reading her articles too.
Oh my gosh, so. It was just amazing. And a lot of pictures with it, and you just felt like you knew this lady.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, I could definitely see in the future loving to do something like that. You know?
I could see you doing that too.
Yeah.
And we're always looking at the paper for new ways to engage the readership.
Right,
and
exactly.
And Emily does such a fabulous job of covering the town, but also then having those special interest type stories.
Yeah. Right, right, because we do want to find new ways just to keep people interested. I mean, we do seem to have a good readership base, but, you know, just to keep it fresh, I think that is something that's important to us.
So. But I remember that it was like I couldn't wait for the next edition, you know
mean,
to come out. And so I even got up a little early on Sunday to read it. So I'm going to keep my eyes open for some kind
would
of
be great.
Series.
Yeah, certainly any idea like that that
yeah, definitely
that you have.
Throw it our way, you know, that would be great. Yeah.
Now, what about if somebody does have an idea for a story for you? How do they get in touch with you? What do they do?
Well, on page 2 every week, my cell phone number and my email are right there with my column. So I would say feel free to call me. You know, some people are often a little sheepish, like they feel like they're bugging me. And it's like, no, you don't understand. This is helping me. This makes my job easier when you're calling me with ideas. It's, you know, one of those things. I encourage anyone, if you have any ideas, you know, give me a call. You know, sometimes just considering the nature of the story, I might have to get back to you. I might have to check with my managing editor just to make sure it's, you know, something that wouldn't be against any of our paper's policies. But as long as it isn't, you know, I love hearing ideas from our readers, from the public. So
now, go ahead. I keep asking.
I was just going to say, is there a general, just in case someone doesn't have the paper with them that has that information, is there a general email or something that people can send information to if they do have something to suggest?
As far as there is, oh goodness, why can I? Why am I blanking on it? Is it the?
I believe it's news.
News at thepostnewspapers.com.
Yeah.
But I'm also edean at thepostnewspapers.com, which isn't very difficult either.
It's
so.
Very easy to remember. Just remember it's plural. Post
right.
Newspapers,
yeah.
And S on the end.
That is one thing I always try to stress to people. It is the Post Newspapers. A lot of people want to leave that mm-hmm. last S off.
So. Now, in the years that you've been here, because you started in 2012.
Yes, I've been here about 6.5 years. Yeah.
So what kind of changes have you seen in Wadsworth?
Well, you know, just some of the, when I first came on here, one of the biggest changes that to me was so much fun was the new high school had just been built. We had the Y, we had the senior center. The first week was actually a story of the farewell party of the old senior center. That was like my first week on the job.
Okay.
I did that. And then I loved that I got to be the reporter for the Post for the Bicentennial. That is something I am still just very proud of.
Oh, sure.
You know, I just love that I got to be, you know, involved in that point of Wadsworth history,
mm-hmm.
you know. But, yeah, I mean, you know, obviously you do see little changes over time, but one of the things that amazes me that is just so steady is that Wadsworth just has a lot of people really just championing it on, you know, that it just seems like somebody's always doing something to make the community better. You know, there are just, mm-hmm. you know, so many different, you know, organizations that just impress me all the time, what they do, their generosity.
Boy, even with our nonprofit fair that we mm-hmm. just did at the Chamber, mm-hmm. it still amazes me. We had 50 or 51 nonprofits that set up,
mm-hmm.
and it still amazes me, even though I know they're all out there.
Right,
you know,
yeah.
they're Chamber members. I'm pretty sure I know at least surfacely what they do, that I could
right.
refer somebody to them. But it is amazing to me that nonprofits that service our community.
Oh, it really, I mean, because I've covered other communities, and it does seem like Wadsworth just really is special in that regard. You just mm-hmm. see a lot more of it here.
Mm-hmm. You know? I think
and
so,
that,
too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I think you do. Is there, you mentioned you so much enjoyed being part of the Bicentennial. Any stories or story that you think, boy, I wish I wouldn't have written that one, or...
you know, I can't think of any offhand. You know, I did, I do remember some of my favorite things were just hearing about some of the characters that came from Wadsworth history.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I remember I loved learning about Myra Johnson, who she was, I think, the first female doctor in Medina County.
Okay.
You know, and I thought she just was fascinating. And Caesar was telling me he remembered her as a kid. I guess she just scared him to death because she was a little bit of a foreboding woman.
Oh, good.
You know, mm-hmm. and but yeah, no, I love parts like that. And, you know, I don't know. I don't know that I would have done anything differently. I was pretty happy with the way things went with that. So.
Well, there was a lot to cover.
Absolutely.
There was, but that was great, you know. I like it when there's a lot going on. I like it when I'm busy. I much prefer that than the weeks when you're like, okay, scrambling for stories. I need to find a way to fill
the
paper.
What am I going to write about?
Yeah, although, you know, it's funny. David Sickles, my managing editor, and I have talked about it. On the weeks where it's looking a little bare, I always remind him, I'm like, David, something always shakes loose. And it does.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we always, and at Wadsworth, luckily, just produces enough news as a community. We always find something.
Boy, and I mean, it just feels like, oh, I can hardly wait for the Post to come on Saturday. In fact, mm-hmm. I hold off on my lunch until. So I got to talk to our postman to see if he could bring it a little earlier.
Yeah.
But anyways, I read that cover to cover, and I am just so impressed with all the news that's in there. And it's not like it's like earth-shaking news that this just happened yesterday or
right,
last night.
Right.
It's our town, what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right. And I think that's important because I think this is why the smaller community newspapers like ours have survived, whereas the Beacon and the Plain Dealer have taken hits. Mm-hmm. Really, where else are you going to find a lot of comprehensive news about Wadsworth, Ohio? You know, and I think that's kind of what, because we kind of have that niche, I think that saved us in a lot of ways.
Yeah, well, it's news that, that you're not generally going to get to your phone. Or, almost everything that the national or the regional papers cover, most of that, if you're truly interested, your phone's telling you the night before when it happens.
Right, exactly.
So you're right, that's a niche that we have, and and Emily, you do a great job with it. I know, for the most part, anywhere you go, everything you hear is positive about you, Emily, and,
and
the great, wonderful
you.
Things.
Yes.
But knowing that, have you had some, ever had any, I can't believe you wrote this about this, negative type emails, calls, or anything?
Oh, I have. And, you know, it's one of those, because actually I had them about two different things, and they were very opposite of each other. A few years ago, I wrote a feature story. This was kind of shortly after Caitlyn Jenner had come into popularity and talked about her journey. And I did a story about a really wonderful woman named Natalie Martin who had transitioned from male to female. And we had a couple of people actually call in, I think maybe it was just one, and wanted to cancel the subscription because they were so angry that I wrote about this. But then a few months later, I was actually in the square and I covered a story about Sacred Heart having a prayer group that they were basically praying that the Supreme Court did not pass the Same-Sex Marriage Act.
Okay.
And both of these things to me were news, you know? And I really like to take pride in the fact that I don't give any sort of political slant, you know? But I had people angry with me for both things, you know? And it's like, I guess I kind of felt like, well, if I'm getting both sides angry at me, maybe I'm doing the right thing.
You're doing your job well.
You know? So.
Yeah, those are pretty polar.
Right,
yeah.
Right. Yeah. But, you know, it just goes to show that you can't always make everybody happy. But I really just try. You know, you see, like, Fox News and MSNBC, and I don't ever want to be that. You know, I want to be the person who just, okay, I'm going to put the facts out. You can come to your own conclusions from that. So.
And you've done a great job with that.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah, that's for sure. Now, I got a couple post questions that I think you're the person to ask.
Okay,
so on the, where people are asked a question, okay, who does that? Who comes up with the question? Who goes?
Oh, as far as, are you talking about like with street talk?
Street talk.
Okay, actually, usually we have a meeting every Thursday morning.
Okay.
And a lot of times we'll brainstorm that then because, you know, it'll be like my Brunswick counterpart and my Northern Wayne counterpart will just kind of talk about different, you know, oh, this is what I'm doing for my zone, you know. So usually that's where that comes up.
So is it the same question throughout all nine editions?
Not necessarily. We have a little bit of autonomy with that. You know, for example, I don't like to ask sports questions. I will admit this, because if I have a sports question and I'm standing outside the Y, which is where I go a lot of times for street talk, I will run into 15 people who are like, yeah, I don't really follow sports. You know, so I tend to like questions that anyone can answer.
Oh, good idea.
Yeah.
That's great. And so you ask the question, you take the picture.
Yeah, I ask the question and take the picture. And, you know, it's amazing how many people are receptive to it, because I always feel like, oh, people must hate it. I'm coming up to them with a camera, approaching them and bugging them. But people are really great. I've actually had, I've been like at the Blue Tip, and kids have come up and asked if they can do it.
Oh, and they seemed
a little sheepish, and it's like, no, you are my new best friend, because thank you so much. I am totally happy for you to come up and ask for that.
See, and I think that's a great point to put out to the people in our community and anywhere else. You need them as much as they need
you. I do. I really do. And the people of this community are fantastic about that. I mean, like I said, I've covered other communities in the past where people are a little bit more standoffish with the media. And you really don't see that here. You know, anytime people think there's something that I should know about, they really are great about approaching me.
Well, you're approachable, and you've got a great
warmth about you. That makes a difference.
You. Yeah, it feels like as soon as you meet you, that you're a friend.
Oh, well, thank you.
Sure, I mean, and that's a gift from God. And that's the absolute truth. But anyways, tell me, what is the absolute best thing about your job?
I think probably the best thing about my job, other than the fact that every day is different,
Is that, I thought you were going to say, other than I get to work with Michael.
Well, but. Yeah, that is quite a perk.
Okay.
Well, and this does actually kind of, you know, fall into this, is because I get to meet so many amazing people.
Yes.
You know, I really, I've met so many dynamic individuals, from seniors, you know, who are just, you know, amazing, like Stan the Man at the Senior Center, if you've
yeah.
ever met him.
Mm-hmm.
Or then, like, high school kids, Sophie Bolter, who just graduated last year, that girl just amazes me, you know, just how together she is and everything. You know, so
please,
it's like,
let me be.
Yeah, it's like, I want to meet her when I grow up, you know, even though I'm like old enough to be your mother, you know.
Sure.
But no, it's just great kind of running the gamut, just, you know, because this town has so many wonderfully dynamic individuals, you
That's
know.
That's true.
You know, even some that, like, because I used to joke about when Major Tom and Major Debbie Grace were in charge of the Salvation Army. Major Debbie just, I was in awe of her, but slightly terrified of her at the same time.
Really?
You know, yes, she just had a presence about her that, you know, felt a little intimate, but I mean, I thought she was amazing, you know, so.
Oh, that's funny, because I never thought of her in those terms. Now, Major Tom,
mm-hmm.
majors, weren't they?
Yeah, they were majors.
Yeah, when I said Major Tom, I thought of that
song.
I know,
yeah.
I know.
But anyways, he was intimidating to me.
Now, see, I felt the opposite, I guess, you know. And it's funny, because I heard him joke about people being afraid of his wife. You know, so it made me realize, okay, I evidently
not the only one.
So. Yeah.
But and I don't say that with, you know, any negative. I mean, I thought she was an amazing woman.
Mm-hmm.
But just she just had a presence about her, and it was like, I felt like, okay, I better mind my P's and Q's and behave myself when I'm around her. So.
Oh my gosh, yeah, she is amazing.
Yeah.
Both of them were great for
Absolutely.
The Salvation Army.
Yeah.
Yeah. So where do you see the paper going?
You know, I definitely I see us just like the series thing. I think that's a great idea. I think we're always going to be looking for new and fresh ideas. I think we're going to, you know, maybe even find ways to include some of the wonderful businesses that advertise with us, you know, in different
mm-hmm.
features, you know, that we end up doing. In fact, Kevin McManus, my Medina counterpart, he recently did this great article for Catholic Schools Week and, you know, got a lot of the Catholic schools who advertise with us involved in that. And, you know, I think you might see more of that in the future, so.
Oh, boy. So I just have to ask, so cover your ears, Michael. What's the worst part about your job?
This is going to be, I have to work with Michael.
That's
actually,
where this one's going to go.
The worst part of my job, and I can say this, and it, even this really isn't that bad, taking sports photos. Every season, we have to go take a picture of every varsity athlete mm-hmm. in our coverage area. That's 14 school
it's
districts.
It's a huge undertaking.
It's a huge undertaking. It takes a lot of time. And I don't want to, you know, a lot of teenagers, they're really great and easy to work with. But sometimes, you know, you just get a group of them together and they're not really following directions all that well and things like that. But that is probably my least favorite part of the job.
So those are for when your stories come out and it's like
right, that way we have like this bank of headshots.
Oh,
so it's
boy.
Like we need it.
Sure.
You know, but it's just it's a lot of work, you know, to get all that done. So
oh, I did not know that.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
That way we don't have to chase all that down.
Right, right. That way
happens.
We have it, you know, but yeah, usually for, you know, a few days, three times a year, you're just inundated with, you know, having to go, and then you have to label them all when you get home, and that's not difficult, but it's time consuming.
Sure.
So.
Yeah, probably more than anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a little time consuming.
Right.
Especially for those athletes like me that say, can you shave, not like I'm an athlete, can you shave about 20 pounds?
Well, you know, occasionally, and it's never happened bad at Wadsworth, but at other schools, you'll get like girls from the tennis or the volleyball team. Oh, can I see my picture? Oh, can I retake it? You know, that it doesn't happen a lot, but it comes up and it's like, okay, no, I've really got to get through all you guys. So.
Have you ever retaken it?
I've done it. I have to admit I've done it for girls before.
And from their mothers, thank you.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh my gosh. So we got to come up with some new ideas for you, but what you've been doing has been absolutely stunning.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah,
thank you.
You are so spot on in your reporting. I have never read an article that you have written, and I read it every week. Anything that I thought was like not, and I not true, but I've been at the meetings that you've been at, you report it spot on.
Oh, well, thank you. I really try to. You know, I mean, I really feel that my job is to get the accurate information out to the community. I think that's important. You know, I think communities need, you know, to have that to be informed mm-hmm. because people can't attend every city meeting and they nope. can't, you know. Mm-mm. So my job is just to try to help make that a little easier for them, but keep them informed is how I feel. So.
Oh, my gosh.
And unlike how some people may feel when someone's being interviewed by the media, you know, the last thing we want to do is, and I know this of you, is to have a gotcha question.
Right,
When you are covering and quoting, mm-hmm. you're generally doing everything you can to put that person in the best light.
I am. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, we're definitely not out to, you know, put a bad spin on anyone. I mean, now, if there's a politician who's laundering money and putting it into a drug ring, I'm not going to ignore that.
Yeah, we're going to be trying.
But, you know, right. but really, you know, that's not something that happens here. So
Must
or hasn't.
Be mentioned.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? We're running out of time already. I can't believe it. But you're so fun to talk to, Emily.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah. And I appreciate everything I send you, you put right in the paper. And I so appreciate that.
Oh, well, you know, like I said, it's people like you and Mike when he finds me stuff. I mean, that's really what keeps the paper going, is the fact that people engage and they're sending us information and letting us know what's going on.
Well, Madam Olga predicts a Pulitzer Prize in the future.
That's
what I predict.
Well, all of there's so many wonderful people in Wadsworth and so many wonderful things about the town, but certainly you're a big portion of that.
Oh, well, thank you.
And you do a great job of highlighting those people and this town. So thank you for all the time and effort you put into doing it.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Yeah, and you make my job a lot easier, too.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah, so thank you. So I guess we better wrap it up.
Have a great week, Wadsworth.
You got it.
Thanks.